Hey YouTube, it's Daniel here. Just wanted to give you another tip here on backing up. I had this specifically for a friend of mine that asked me about how to back up to an external hard drive. He got one, so we're going to use a program here called Cobian Backup and how to use that. There's so many different programs out there that you can use and copy and paste methods that don't involve any software. But we want to do something here with the software. It can automate the process because most of the time you're going to be backing up the same files or at least the same folders that contain different files. But as long as it's within that same folder, like My Documents, for example, or stuff on your desktop, you can just tell it, look for whatever's in those locations, back that up. Then with the click of a button, you got everything backed up. Anyway, let's have a look at the software. There's many different backups available online that you can use. Different ways of backing up. This is one here, Cobian Backup. If you do a Google search for Cobian Backup, the first thing in the list you can click on and it takes you to their website. And on that page, the first item is the latest version of this program, which you can download. You can save it or run it, doesn't matter. It's a small file, so you can just hit run and it'll start immediately. And hit yes. Now, depending if you're on XP or Vista or Windows 7, you may get more prompts to install as you're going along. Now, if nothing shows up on your screen like it's doing to me, you can minimize what's up there currently. So now we can see this was hiding in behind that window. I'll just hit OK, accept the terms, next, and you can change these options, but really we're just going to accept the defaults and everything will be fine. Now, actually, with this one here, I wouldn't leave it to go as a service just in case. If you know the login information or you have special things with the services, it may not work properly. So I do it as an application and auto start for all users. So it doesn't matter who logs in, it's going to run this program. Next, it goes through, it says it's installing. Now, for me, I've already had the program installed, so of course it's going through an uninstall first. But for you, you would just get this window. And it's done. Installation completed successfully. Done. And it's done. That's it. Now, down by your time, you're going to see this little red mushroom, which says Cobian Backup and the version of it, if you hover the mouse over it. And if you double click on it, it opens up the program. So, now, I've already got a backup set up here, but what we're going to do is go through a new one. So you'd hit this to create a new task. And give it a name if you want, any name, daily or just leave it. It doesn't really matter. You don't really need to change anything here. Something important here is this feature here. If unchecked, existing backs will be overwritten. Ideally, you want to have it checked, and it'll create separate backups using timestamps, so you can have multiple backups on different days on the same drive, which is great. And a full backup, if it's not a massive amount of data to backup, it's a good idea to do a full backup every time. If it's 100 gigs worth of data, you probably want to do it as an incremental, so it's only going to back up files that were changed since the last backup, rather than doing everything full. And then you got a differential, which is similar, but it only backs up the files changed since the last full backup. So this can increase in size with each backup, but the incremental will pretty much be the same size each backup. It's only changed files. The next step is choosing what files you want to back up. So you go and add directory and choose probably your desktop and your My Documents, you know, maybe downloads, that sort of thing. So you would choose what it is you want to back up. And with each folder, it will list them here. And then you've got the destination where you want it to back up to. Now, I've already got something in here. I had it go into the F drive, so you can choose a directory and whatever the drive letter is of your external hard drive. You can hit the arrows to the left of each thing here to minimize and maximize or expand and so on. And choose where it's going to back up to so it shows the destination. So now you've got what's being backed up and where is it going to. That's the most basic thing right there. And in the general tab is where we chose this option of keeping them separate. So this is all, if you get this wrong, doesn't even matter. As long as it's doing at least a full backup, you can't even go too wrong on here at all. Just where is it coming from, where is it going to, and then your schedule. By default, it's set to go to daily, and you can set up a schedule. I like the manual route, so you can just go down and choose manually from the drop-down menu. And don't even worry about these other features. This is something else we can get into on another video, but basically get that going. Once it's all set up, I just canceled out of it, but you would hit OK, and you can see what's being backed up, where is it going to, and what's the total size of the backup. Now you guys know how much stuff I'm backing up. And the other options that you've chosen. So you can see all the detail about it here. And you can see I do mine manually. And that's it. So when you open this program, you would highlight this and hit to run this selected task. Or run all the tasks. If there's only one, it doesn't matter which one you choose. One other feature now is if you go to Tools and Options, I just got to show you this because this is very helpful. Go to Visuals, and there is Show Percent in the Progress Bar. By default, that is not turned on, so you want to check that on and hit OK, and then it will show the percentage of each file as it's backing up, as well as the overall progress. This is great to watch while it's backing up. And when it's done, you can see a history of the backups that they were being done, and you'll see a log at the very end, and it'll have black text going all the way down. And as long as there's no red text, then everything should have worked properly. Best way to find out that your backups are working, which you should always do, is actually just go into my computer and open up that drive letter, browse to the location where it backed up, and make sure the files are actually there. That's pretty much it. Alright, so I hope you found that this tip useful, and please subscribe if you can, and if you like the videos, it helps to build up more videos, and I love getting the feedback as well. It helps with making further videos, and yeah, that's it. Thanks a lot, guys. Happy holidays to those, especially if you're not celebrating Christmas, whatever it is you're celebrating this time of year. Have a great, safe time, and a great new year as well. All right, thanks a lot, guys. Take care. Bye.